Good afternoon to all of you, and a very warm welcome to our press friends from all different English and vernacular medium. Thank you for coming here and joining us. And a special welcome to Ms. Diana Penty. Thank you for being here with us. A big thank you to both our Malar chairperson, Gauri, and the vice chairperson for Confluence, Amita, and Father Rector, Dr. Keith D'Souza, for being here at the St. Xavier's College Malar press conference. Malar 2018, a time turner. So it seeks to reflect on the milestones of Malar and St. Xavier's College Autonomous Mumbai. It also aims to look at the future and the goals yet to be achieved. Malar 2018 aspires to challenge the participants, the audience, and the organizers with innovative events and inventive methods of approaching pre-existing structures. This year, we hope to encourage and boost talent while also developing an inclusive and inventive outlook. This is being done via Confluence, our speaker conference, as well as the various events that Malar hosts. We are extremely glad that our alumnus from the BMM batch of 2006, Ms. Diana Penty, is here to reveal the lineup for the Confluence. Malar is also 40 years this time. It began in 1979, and that first year was an intercollegiate affair. The second year, in 1980, Malar opened its doors to all colleges of Mumbai. I'm happy to say that I was a participant in the Malar of 1980. I was in FYJC at that time, and I remember playing for the Western Instrumental, and I played a piano boogie for that competition. Inaugural Mass, which is going to be on 29 December, and the inaugural function on January 3rd. But we do hope that all of you continue to be diversity, inclusiveness, innovation. Father Keith, vision statement, and these are the three key words of the vision statement. And we do hope that each one of you can...
of Malar and her insight on this esteemed lineup. It's
a really eminent list of people there. You guys are really lucky. Well, thanks for having me. That's what I wanted to say first and foremost. Thank you, Charlotte, for inviting me and for all of you to agree to have me. I haven't been able to come back to college as often as I would like to, but this is a great opportunity. I've spent five of the most formative years of my life here on this campus, right from FYJC all the way through. And I think that those years have defined who I've become today. I kind of came into my own, started off as a complete freshman, had no idea, had no direction, was like a headless chicken, and then now here I am today. I have a long way to go, but at least I'm not where I began. So, I mean, it's been a pleasure to be at Xavier's, and I feel that the what's most special about it is that besides the academics, which of course, you know, we give a lot of importance to and we have the best faculty in the country, but besides that, Xavier's has always given a lot of focus on extracurricular activities and overall development, which I feel is what sets it apart from, you know, other colleges out there. And that is what has made me who I am today. I remember when I first joined college in FYJC, everybody used to say, oh, she's the tallest girl, let's put her on every fashion show that there was. And I, at that point, was so intimidated by anything remotely that was in the spotlight that I used to shy away from it and say, I'm tall, but I mean, I have nothing else. Like, I have no makings of a model. Because I didn't. I mean, I was this gawky, awkward teenager, and, you know, like all teenagers are. I had no idea how to walk the ramp. Anything that put me in the spotlight would make me run the opposite direction. So I said, there's no way I'm doing this. But you know, the committee said, no, give it a shot, come for one of the rehearsals, and if you really don't like it, you can drop out. So I said, okay, fine, I had the option of dropping out. So I went for one of the rehearsals, and since then I did every single fashion show that I was in college. And who knew at that time, 4 years down the line, I was going to be a professional model. I had no idea. But it happened. And so what I'm saying is that, I mean, this is just a really small little example, but Xavier's really does throw opportunities at you. And if you don't grab them, if you don't take them, you know, you're losing out. So it's important to, you know, be part of every, you know, debate, discussion, whether it's sports or it's dance or music or, you know, even participating in Malhar, because you never know the potential that you have, and you only realize it along the way, you know, once you try your hand at different things. So I have a lot to thank Xavier's for. I've participated in about 3 Malhars out of the 5 that I was here for. The first time I was in a department called Performances Incorporated, which was Pink, which I don't think exists anymore. Does it exist? No. Because I think that was the last year that Pink was around. And they used to organize music nights. I think it was like a concert night. Yeah, the most exciting. And at that time we got KK, I remember, to come and perform. I don't know if you guys are familiar with him, but he was a rage back then, with biggest hits. And it was the most exciting time because A, we got to meet KK, and you know, we got to like witness this super performance in the night on the basketball court, if I remember right. And I was so excited. And of course, at that time I was a junior, so what did they make me do? They made me dress up as a witch with a witch cap, and we stirred this huge pot right next to the stage. I don't know for what reason. I have no idea what the witch had to do with KK or what the pot had to do with any of this, but I was like, I'm going to put my 100% into this and become the best witch pot stirrer, which I don't think anybody ever remembered after that. I have pictures for proof. Second year, I said, okay, this time I'm going to do something a little cooler. So I decided to join the technical department, commonly called techs. TEXXXXXX or something like that. And we're still around, techs, yeah? So lights and sound, and I'm going to become like this really cool, you know, master at putting music systems together, and you know, they're going to teach me all these things. But of course, I was a junior again, so I was told to carry this wire from that end of the campus to the other end and bring some 2 speakers, and like, it was all the up and down running around the world. But I still got to learn a lot. And finally, in my last year, I said, now I'm a senior, finally. I'm going to be cool about this. And I'm going to join like the chilled most department that doesn't have much to do, but you've got to walk around with a chip on your shoulder and like, you're cool, everyone's scared of you. So security. So I was there, I was in the security department. I have no idea what makes now when I look back. And I was like, okay, we had crisp people, literally like feeling up people up and down for most of the day, and then maybe, you know, hoping that somebody would like walk in with some suspicious item that we could then create some drama about and say, you're not allowed into Xavier's, we're going to carry this on you, and nothing of that ever happened. But it was fun, and you know, we got to just mix and interact with so many different people, seniors, juniors, it didn't matter, otherwise you're only, you know, amongst the people of your class. So it was just an overall development, which the person that I am today, I feel the confidence that I gained when I was in college, the reason I'm able to do what I am doing today, you know, I didn't know modeling would finally lead to acting, and here I am, and I have a long way to go, but the reason I am who I am today is because of Xavier's, because those were the most special years of my life. And I would also say that the friendships that, you know, I formed in those 5 years being here, they're still like the best friends that I have today are friends from college. So, you know, all I want to say to you guys is that you're really lucky to be here in an institute such as Xavier's, and, you know, make good use of it. Of course, you know, with your bunking of classes and all that, which we all did. Don't. But make sure you balance it out and, you know, take part in all the activities that you can. Broaden your horizons, because that's what it does, participate in all the debates and the discussions. Whatever you can just do as much as you can, because it betters you for later, and it just gives you experiences that you can look back at, and it will help you somewhere along the way. So, you know, grab every opportunity that comes your way, and thank the stars that you're at Xavier's.
Thank you, Diana. The floor is now open for an interactive session with our chief guest. We would kindly request you to ask her questions pertaining to Malhar and this college. We would highly appreciate it if you refrain from asking her any personal questions. Thank you.
Questions on Malhar? Okay. I don't know what goes on anymore. I was hoping that
you would.
wouldn't mention what batch I like graduated from. So I let them think I'm younger than that. But anyway, what questions do you have for me? See, nobody has any questions for me. But somebody was raising their hand, so they said pink.
Yeah,
we are performing art. Oh. Okay. How many pink and how many security and how many techs? Who's going?
Okay, so I'm Indian performing arts and she's
so pink mentioned Indian performing arts and she's performing arts.
Yeah, so basically we organize events which are
performance-based.
Very performance-based. Like Indian aspects, yeah.
So, and who's the technical team? Lots of girls. And now we're security. I know you're security. Nice. All seniors only get to join security or something like that. Only seniors, no? For security.
No, no, no. I
don't think I'm equal and fair for all. Questions?
So since you were actively participating in Malhar for 3 years, what was your favorite Malhar mode?
I think the KK concert was my favorite one. I was a full fan of that. I have those pictures. Nobody else discovers them. But I was made to stand in the corridor right next to the mall, outside the mall, and stir a large pot of imaginary broth while KK crooned away in the background.
Was it a Harry Potter theme that year?
No, I don't think. No. I don't think Harry Potter's are double. I don't know what it is, but yeah, that's what I think. What are you guys doing for Malhar this time? Is anything special? I noticed the concerts are back.
Yeah.
Because that stopped in between for a while.
Does anyone from dress have any questions?
Come away. Come away.
Important things that I learned at them. And of course, you're going to interact with a lot of different people, different ages, spanning from FYJC to the senior year. So I think it's like an overall development that happens without you even realizing it. And I did learn something about, you know, what a jack is and like what a what is this SLR to jack and something in here. And I actually can put things together from my tech experience.
Thank you.
What makes Malhar Malhar for you? Like even after all these years, what brings you back?
It was just an exciting vibe and time, and we used to work sometimes through the night. I don't know whether that's allowed anymore, but we used to. I mean, we really gave it our all. And so while it was also a really fun time because we got to spend time with our friends, the new friends we had made, and you know, the groups that we were in, we also did a lot of productive work, I feel. And to pull off something that was in those days, and I'm sure still is one of the biggest inter-college festivals, which requires a certain amount of production, you know, and behind the scenes, and you know, a few days of planning, and a few months of planning, but a few days of actually putting things together and building stages, and you know, getting the music set up right, and organizing, and it did take a lot. So I feel that when I think back now, I have in fact one more shelf of my cupboard only has my Malhar t-shirts of all the different colors of all the different years and all the different departments. I still have those t-shirts. So every time I open my cupboard and look at those, I remember Malhar.
All of us have this one favorite professor that is most approachable and that we remember even after going out of college. So who is that one professor for you?
Miss Linda. She should be my psychology. So she was like one of my most favorite teachers. And then I remember Miss Pratibha, who was political science, who I dreaded because she was so strict. But she was such a good teacher, but she was just so strict that, I mean, every time she entered the class, I think everybody was so petrified that there would be a pin drop silence. So I will never forget her because of that. And I always used to admire her immaculate dressing.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Does anyone from the press have any questions?
Janta bite kare.
Is anyone from B&M here?
Yeah.
Oh.
Thank you so much. Refreshments will be available outside.
बहुत सारे memories हैं. Actually, I've just finished telling you about a lot of them. मैंने बहुत बार मल्हार में भी participate की थी. And मल्हार का memories बहुत अच्छा है because we had, you know, everyone has to work together as a group, as a team, and you know, we got to learn so much along the way. And of course, it was like the biggest inter-college festival at that time, and is still today. So it was just a good feeling to be part of something that was, you know, spoken about and something that was so famous.
Okay, अगर आपके अंदर बात करिए तो आप सबसे ज़्यादा क्या miss करती हैं अपने college time का जो
आप सबसे ज़्यादा canteen college का canteen जो है, it's like the best place to hang out and chill, and the best Chinese food, the best dosas, the best like everything. Chai was in the canteen, and of course we used to all the friends used to hang out together. So you miss those memories, and you miss hanging out together, like, because now everybody's doing different things, everyone's busy in their lives, we don't catch up so much. But in college we used to spend every day together, so I think that's something that I miss a lot.
College cultures mein kafi departments hote hain, to aap kaun se department mein the aur kya kuch seekha?
एक बार मैं परफॉर्मेंसेज डिपार्टमेंट में थी और दैट दे ऑर्गेनाइज ऑल द वेरियस परफॉर्मेंसेज द कॉन्सर्ट्स जो भी होते थे उस वक्त एंड सो आई वाज इन देयर वंस. फिर दूसरी बार आई थिंक आई वाज इन टेक्निकल्स जो लाइट एंड साउंड के बारे में जो यू नो सब ऑर्गेनाइज करते हैं तो मैं उस डिपार्टमेंट में थी. और तीसरी बार आई वाज इन सिक्योरिटी हैंडल करते हैं गेट के वहाँ. सो दैट इज़ द मोस्ट लाइक प्रेस्टिजियस सिक्योरिटी प्लेस टू बी बिकॉज यू आर अलाउिंग पीपल टू कम इन एंड देन यू आर मेकिंग श्योर दैट यू नो दे डोंट हैव एनी लाइक शार्प आइटम्स और एनीथिंग दैट्स नॉट अलाउड एंड सॉर्ट ऑफ फ्रिस्क देम एंड देन यू हैव टू. सो इट वाज लाइक यू नो वन ऑफ द मोस्ट एक्साइटिंग थिंग्स फॉर अस बैक इन द डे. सिक्योरिटी वाज लाइक द कूलेस्ट डिपार्टमेंट टू बी इन. किसके बारे में? आई वॉज मैं लाइक बहुत सीधी सादी लड़की थी. आई सो नॉट आई मीन आई टू अटेंड ऑल मोस्ट क्लासेज. कभी कभी बंक करते थे बट एवरीबडी यूज टू बंक एंड सो वी टू समटाइम्स बंक क्लास एंड देन गो एंड सिट इन द कैंटीन एंड स्पेंड द होल डे देयर. समटाइम्स वी हैव बंक द होल डे लाइक ऑल द पीरियड्स वी हैव मिस्ड एंड जस्ट सैट इन द कैंटीन एंड चिल. But that's the most. I've never advised you. Xavier is generally quite strict. You can't do too much, you know, and get away with it. So. Trailer release होने वाला है 24th, 25th पे. So on Wednesday. I know it was on Wednesday. So. इस बार दो है. बस वो ही कह सकती हूँ मैं. I can't say more. You have to watch the trailer. Thank you. No, I've never participated in Miss Malhar actually. Because I was always in the organizing committees. So I never participated.